Good day, everybody. In this video, I will explain how we can use RocPlane software of RocScience. And we're going to look at the planar failure. So this is how it's going to look like. This is sort of like 3D animation. So this is the rock wedge that can go down if the stability is very low. And we're going to use the same example that I used in my previous video to explain the formulas behind this procedure. And I showed you how to do hand calculation. I'm going to put a link to that video in the description of this video. So please check that one beforehand so that you have a better understanding of what I'm talking about. And we just copy that case and then just use software to estimate the safety factor for different scenarios cases. So to start with, I want to go to analysis and I want to change project settings. So in the units, I want to change it to KPA. So we change it to KPA. And then because why KPA? Because we're going to use cohesion, which is in KPA, and the unit weight we use kilonewton per cubic meters. Okay. So now we're going to input data. And the data that we're going to use exactly the same as in the example in the previous video. So the height in that example was 12 meters, the height of the slope. Then the slope face angle was 60 degrees. And the angle of the failure plane was 35. It's already preset for 35. The unit weight of rocks was 26, put 26 here. And there is no upper face here. I will set it to zero. And then just click OK. And then what I can also do, just look at analysis and 2D view. So this is very common. You can see it in all textbooks, how it's presented and explained. So you see that the height of the slope is 12 meters, and we have angles 35, which is the failure plane, is this one. And 60 degrees of slope angle here. So we have driving forces and we have normal force, right? That will prevent this rock mass from sliding down. Okay, so in the example that we're going to use, we're going to use a tension crack. So I'm gonna go back to analysis, input data, and I will tick this box, tension crack. We don't change the angle, usually it's vertical tension crack. We can add specific location, and this will be 4 meters from the crest. And again, I'm going to click OK. So now we have a tension crack here. And as we put the tension crack here, well, we can also see the safety factor, right? It's still 1. So next step is we're going to add data about the strength of the rock mass. And we're going to use more column failure criteria. The friction angle that we used in the previous video was 37. Friction angle was 37 degrees. And the cohesion was 25 kPa. So now we're going to click OK. So you see that the safety factor increased to 1.54. So, and that was the safety factor that we obtained in the previous video for dry slope conditions when we have no groundwater or water in the tension crack. So this is exactly the same thing. Another thing that we can get here in the geometry, wedge weight. So in the previous video, I showed you the formula, how to calculate this wedge weight, and it was 1,241. Kilonewton per meters. And another thing that I showed you how to estimate in the previous videos using the formula, it was value of A, which is failure plane length is 13.3 meters. So that's exactly what we got there. In the previous video, when we did hand calculation, we were given tension crack length 4.35. So in this case, we didn't set it up. We just put the distance from the crest 4 meters, and the software estimated the tension crack length for us. Okay. These other parameters, that's what we already input, which is friction angle and cohesion 25 kPa. Okay, so let's look at the case where we have groundwater, and we're going to have groundwater in the tension crack. So I'm going to go back to analysis, input data, and click on water. So I'm going to tick this plain water pressure, and I'm going to change it to peak pressure TC base, so tension crack base. So that's what we analyzed in the previous video. And we're going to look at the worst case scenario when that tension crack is completely filled with water. So in this case, it will be 100%. So now I'm going to click OK. And you see that safety factor dropped to 1.07. And that's exactly the safety factor that we obtained for groundwater conditions in the previous videos. So here you'll see this will be uplift force from groundwater acting on the base of the rock wedge. And we call it U. So that will be this value, 284.5. In the previous video, I explained how to use the formula to calculate this number. And this value, that will be additional driving force that comes from the water pressure acting on the tension crack. So in the previous video, I call it V, and also show the formula, and the number is 92.7. So that's exactly what we got in the previous video. Okay, so you see that safety factor dropped to 1.07, so it makes sense. When there is water pressure, it will decrease the stability of rock mass, but it's still stable, right, because it's more than one. Okay, now let's look at the seismic component. We also did it in the previous video. I'm going to go to input data and click on this tab forces and tick seismic. In the previous video, we used the coefficient 0.08, and then we use directional horizontal because that will be the worst case scenario. Going to click OK. So you see that safety factor dropped to 0.92, right? So that's exactly what we got when we did hand calculations. Right. So, of course, if there's a seismic shaking, maybe due to earthquake or any other shaking vibration, so it will decrease the stability. And you see that safety factor drop below one, which means the slope becomes unstable. So, and the final one, let's see what we can do, how we can stabilize the slope. Maybe we can use anchors. And this software gives you this option. To do that, I need to go to analysis and change to 3D view. And then you see this menu option support. And then we're going to click this one, add bolt. So we're going to add bolt somewhere in the middle. Doesn't really matter where it is. We're going to put, this is plunge, so this is actually a pretty cool option, so you can play with that one and change the angle at which you're going to install that anchor, the bolt. So you will see that when this angle decreases, then the stability will increase. So let's just put something like 35 degrees, just for example, right, and click OK. So you see here there is a bolt anchor going through, and we can also add some other parameters to that one. So we can go to bolt properties, and I believe an example before in the previous video we use just force. So we added force, which was 400 kilonewton per meter. So we can do the same thing and click OK. So you see that it recalculated the safety factor. Now it's 1.4. So before it was unstable because of the effect of water and seismic loading. But if we add anchor here with a force of 400 kilonewton per meters, you will see that safety factor will increase, right? So as I said, you can just look at design of the slope and come up with slightly different values and see which one will give a better factor of safety. Okay, Thanks for watching this video and bye. So to